A boy ate 75 chicken nuggets every day for 7 years. This is what happened to his eyes. MN is a 15-year-old boy presenting to the emergency room with something happening to his eyes. About 2 months ago, he noticed bad things happening. He'd wake up in the morning and he just couldn't see. Everything was dark. Things got better as the day passed, but then worse again at night. He told his parents, they brought him to the eye doctor, and by every objective measure, the eye doctor didn't find anything wrong. MN was as healthy as can be. See you next year. And he was on his way. But every morning, things just kept getting worse. MN was a picky eater. One day when he was a toddler, his dad, Matt, gave him a dinosaur chicken nugget, and it was over. It basically became the only thing that he'd eat every day. Sometimes he'd add candy gummies, low-cost chocolate bars, and a juice drink that was made with 3% juice. And it had to be the exact same juice from the exact same style container, otherwise he wouldn't drink it. And if his dad so much as poured just a little glass for himself, MN would totally refuse to drink that bottle. One evening, Matt prepared some different food for his son. MN didn't like it and threw it against the wall, throwing a temper tantrum until finally he got the dinosaur chicken nuggets that he knew and loved. Every day, he would eat at least 75 nuggets as his only source of sustenance. Frustrated, Matt gave up because he just didn't have the mental capacity to fight with his son over something so trivial. Good thing this kid only eats cheap stuff, he thought. MN liked to play video games, but one day, his parents saw that he was just staring at the wall instead. Must realize how cringe these games are, his dad thought. MN liked to watch meme videos on his phone, but one day, his parents saw him just staring at his hands instead. Maybe can't stand the secondhand embarrassment from this brain rot slop, his dad thought. Skin deep, it looked like MN wasn't even paying attention to what he was doing, but in reality, he couldn't see straight ahead. It was only when he looked indirectly that he could see what he wanted to see from the side of his field of view. But very quickly, he couldn't even do that. MN would walk into walls so hard that it would knock him down just because he couldn't see anymore. One morning, when he woke up, he was literally screaming and crying because everything was dark, despite it being sunny outside. And when they finally couldn't take it anymore, his parents drive him to the emergency room, where we are now. At examination, the medical team didn't notice anything immediately life-threatening in MN, except a blood test revealed that it took a little longer than normal for his blood to clot. Not a huge problem, could mean a lot of different things, including something wrong with his liver, but everything else was normal. He wasn't cognitively impaired, he wasn't missing reflexes, he didn't have a fever, and he wasn't swollen anywhere. He had no signs of traumatic injury. It was only the fact that MN really couldn't see anything at all. An MRI of his head reveals nothing. It's basically normal too, except there might be something happening to the optic nerve going to both eyes. And given that he complained both eyes had gone dark, this could mean something's happening, but what could it be? Well, there's some basic physiology to be known here. Light shines in through the eye from the cornea, and then it goes through the aqueous humor, the lens, and then the vitreous humor. This focuses the light onto the retina in the back of the eye, where it's transformed into an electrical signal going through the optic nerve into the brain, where it's interpreted. And this is where the first clue is. If his vision was blurry, then maybe something is scattering the light up by the front of his eye, but his vision was dark, not blurry. That could mean that light is getting blocked out instead, but that's not happening because the medical team shined a light into his eyes to see what was wrong, and the light passed through. Light gets to his retina, but he can't see it, meaning that his problem might be at his retina. The light isn't getting transformed into an electrical signal, or that signal isn't getting sent to his brain, a problem of his optic nerve. This could mean that he has a retinopathy, apathy from ancient Greek pathos, referring to a distress state, or in this case, a disease state, or he has an optic neuropathy. And given that the MRI showed that something might be wrong in his optic nerve, this not only gives the medical team some idea of what's wrong, but it also tells them that MN's problem might be very serious. He may not be able to get his vision back. And to figure out exactly what's happening, they have to think of all the possibilities of why the optic nerve and or retina would have this kind of problem. And based on what they know about him and what they can find out about him, reason out which ones to exclude. This will quickly narrow down what tests are needed so that they can get him the treatment that he needs. We know that his vision had been slowly getting worse recently, happening over a time span of several weeks. What if his problem had been brewing since he was younger and it just came to a head now? Well, MN is 15 years old. His medical record noted that he was born prematurely. And this is important because nerves can be damaged when a baby is delivered prematurely. One problem that happens is that they won't get enough oxygen. This hypoxemia, hypo meaning low, ox referring to oxygen, and emia, meaning presence in blood, is something that can impact the brain and cause neurologic damage. But at 15, and not having experienced blindness like this at a much earlier age, this likely isn't the problem. Sometimes a mass will grow in the brain or the skull, and it'll push against the optic nerve, blocking it. That can cause optic neuropathy too, but he's too young for that to be likely, and the MRI didn't show that mass, so these aren't the problem. But something that could be the problem is his immune system. Autoimmune optic neuropathy, auto referring to self, so the immune system attacking the body, is called optic neuritis, itis referring to inflammation. Infections also activate the immune system, and if they're in the eye, that can cause someone to go blind. But he didn't have a fever. He didn't have swelling in his eyes. Infection or an autoimmune attack causes blindness much quicker than the several weeks that happened to MN. Some people say junk food inflames the body. They might not be wrong, but nothing points to MN having eye damage because of inflammation or infection, so this isn't his problem either. Do you remember that MN would stare at the wall instead of directly looking at his video games, and that he would look at his hands while watching videos on his phone? Well, he felt it easier to see from the side of his eye rather than looking directly. This is called eccentric viewing, and it's characteristic of the kind of vision loss that's associated with genetic, toxic, and nutritional deficiency optic neuropathy, narrowing down his problem. Genetic. Could it be the case? His parents weren't blind, their parents weren't blind. It doesn't totally rule it out, but it makes it unlikely, and the medical team can test for it, and that's that. But it's the toxic and nutritional parts that prompt the medical team to ask MN's parents the interesting questions. His parents talked about how picky their son is. They reveal the copious amounts of chicken nuggets every day, the candy gummies, the low-cost sugary chocolate, and the juice drink that was made with 3% juice. Which one of these were contaminated with toxins? Well, a lot of people may not disagree if you said all of them, but the better question would be, which toxin causes blindness? And blindness alone, nothing else. Well, juice drinks have been found to contain lead. And that's not to scare you about juice. These stories come up every once in a while. But lead damages neurologic tissue, but the poisoning doesn't usually cause blindness. And if it did, it doesn't just cause blindness. There would be other symptoms like stomach pain, cognitive impairment, muscle weakness, problems walking, none of which MN had. This is more or less what you would get with most other heavy metals too. So we can be fairly confident that he hasn't been poisoned with heavy metals in his food. What other toxins can be found contaminating these foods? How about poisonous alcohols like methanol? This happens sometimes too, but there's an easy way to tell if this is what's happening. MN had a blood test when he presented to the emergency room. Methanol is similar to ethanol, the alcohol in adult beverages. In the body, both get metabolized and broken down by the same enzymes. It's just that because they're different chemicals, they're broken down to different chemicals. Ethanol's metabolites cause hangover, but methanol's metabolite is a toxic acid, causing blindness. And that's the thing, his blood isn't acidic, it's actually a little basic, so not methanol poisoning. But speaking of blood, do you remember that it took a little longer than normal for his blood to clot? Well, vitamin K is the nutrient that's involved in forming blood clots. If his blood is taking longer than normal to clot, and vitamin K is needed to make these clots, then it could mean that he's somehow deficient in vitamin K. This isn't the cause of his blindness, rather, it totally changes the mindset. Rather than MN consuming a toxin causing blindness, maybe his problem is that he's not consuming enough essential nutrients instead. And this was the only abnormal value in that standard blood test. These don't test for anything directly or related to specific vitamins or micronutrients until they're ordered. At this realization, the medical team probed further. They asked MN's parents how strictly he ate this way, and his parents laid it out. He meticulously ate just chicken nuggets every day for several years, and once he figured out how to heat up the nuggets himself, they just let the kid do whatever he wanted. But if this is the case, then what nutritional deficiencies can cause blindness? One is vitamin B12. It builds the nerves in the body, and its deficiency degrades many nerves in the body. It doesn't seem like this is what was happening to MN because all of his reflexes were intact, so none of his other nerves other than the optic nerve seem to be impacted. Copper and zinc are necessary for retinal function, and without them, it can result in decreased vision. All three of these can be tested for deficiency in blood, but there's one more vitamin for the medical team to consider. Vitamin A is a name for a group of chemicals that in the body are responsible for a cycle that supports turning light into the electrical signal that the brain can interpret. In deficiency, these structures are no longer maintained and blindness starts to settle in, possibly ending in permanent damage because of atrophy. Looking at the nutrition facts of the only foods that MN would eat, vitamin A was nowhere to be found. Copper and zinc were absent too. And given that MN's selective eating behavior wouldn't permit for him to even take a multivitamin or supplemental nutrients, all of this makes sense. His optic neuropathy is from a nutritional deficiency caused by eating only chicken nuggets every day for at least 7 years, adding up to half of his entire lifetime. If he's deficient in nutrients and it's causing his problems, then the answer is to give him those nutrients. In the hospital, he was administered vitamins A, B1, B6, B12, C, D, K, as well as copper and zinc. Eventually, over time, his nutrient levels came back to normal, but this was the easy part. Micronutrient deficiency is rare in the United States. There are, of course, some questionable elements to the food supply at the moment, and not everything is totally perfect, but Americans do not have a lack of food availability in a way that you might see elsewhere. However, the mind is very powerful, and sometimes selective eating can become so extreme for so long that it can leave behind permanent damage, which is what happened to MN. Weeks after he was discharged from the hospital, his parents confirmed that MN was more open to eating a variety of different foods. At follow-up, he was noted to have normal vitamin and micronutrient levels. However, his vision loss was so severe and so advanced when he presented to the emergency room because of his intense selective eating and the resulting nutritional deficiency that the damage couldn't be reversed. His vision did not improve. He was deemed legally blind and registered with the state for disability as he was not able to make a recovery. Food and diet is hard to gauge. This was an extreme case, but sometimes things happen in not so extreme circumstances. In my own adult life, I did experience a bit of a micronutrient deficiency once, remedied just by taking a generic multivitamin, no specific brand, and making a conscious effort to eat a greater variety of healthy foods. Thanks so much for watching. Take care of yourself and be well.